Hey guys, it's Peter and welcome to my channel, Peter Likes Books. Okay, so a little comment on my little thing that I do at the beginning every time. Somebody said that there is an app that I can get on my phone to do the scream voice, because you know I've mentioned that like a couple times that I want to have that. But I can't find it. So if you know what it is, let me know in the comment section below because I want to get it. Anyway, I was going to stop doing review videos of books, which is part of the reason why I started this channel, because it seemed like people weren't super interested when I would do a review. It's like people wanted to see like book hauls and my weekend booktube and all that kind of stuff, but they didn't really want to see like reviews. But I was like, you know, as an author, I love to read people's reviews, whether they're good or bad. I feel like I learn from them. And so I wanted to do reviews because I love to read. And so I want to talk about a book at length. And so the first book that I'm going to do, since deciding that I wasn't going to do reviews, I've done like four already. Anyway, I don't know what I'm talking about, but I want to talk about today, The List by Siobhan Vivian. Because I have mentioned this on many of my Vivian videos. I've mentioned on my videos many times that I was trying to get through this book and I couldn't. And I liked it at the beginning and then I didn't like it. And then I don't know what happened, but I just kind of like lost my mind. And anyway, so it's so funny because when I like play back my videos, I can hear my dogs walking around and they're like driving me crazy. So anyway, Boo Radley's like right down here. See? Hi, Boo. Did you read this book? He didn't read this book. So anyway, I was currently reading Peter. Come on now. As of yesterday, I was reading four books and I was like, I have to just finish one of these books. And so last night I went down to the front porch. This video is like so lost its mind already. Anyway, I sat on the front porch last night with my four books and I was like, I am going to finish one of these books tonight. And I didn't really think this was going to be the book that I was going to finish. In fact, I was like only a third of the way through it and I liked it. It wasn't that I didn't like it. It was like, I don't know. It was like kind of all over the place. It's okay. So it's split up into sections by days and it takes place in 1 week. And then within the weeks or days, it's split up into characters. And so there's like so much to keep going. It's kind of like watching a TV show a little bit. So here's the deal with the book. The book is about these girls that go to Mount Washington High School. And they're the week of homecoming, like that Monday, every year, annually, for like tons of years, there's this anonymous list that's put out with the ugliest and the prettiest girl for every class. And nobody knows who makes the list up, but it's like this huge honor to be the prettiest girl. And then it's like devastating if you're the ugliest girl. So you already see where this is going a little bit, okay? And I thought, well, this is kind of trite high school stuff, which is really what I love to read. So why would I have such an issue reading, you know, another book like that? But anyway, but I do like young adult that has intention. So like I wanted to have some kind of thing to it behind it. And I got like a third of the way through and I was like, I don't even know that I'm going to finish this book. But like, it just kept on like glaring at me. And I was like, I do like it. Like, I don't dislike the characters. Here's the thing about this book. The characters are so well developed. Okay, you guys are going to, you think that I'm going to say that I didn't like this book, right? Well, let me just tell you, I sat on my front porch last night and I finished this book in one sitting and it was so fantastic. I loved this book. And let me just tell you that the whole time, and like this isn't even, like the book is really about the characters and what happens to the prettiest girls and what happens to ugliest girls and all that kind of stuff. And it's really about redefining beauty terms. I'm like spitting at the camera. It's like really redefining what we term as beautiful in society and kind of breaking those barriers, which I love. But what's so funny is about, like in the last third, I was like, oh, I know who did the list. Because that you're kind of like wanting to figure that out. You know you're going to find out by the end, like, who did the list, who made the list. And I thought I had it figured out. And I mean, seriously, like, I turned the page and then it was like about that. And who I thought made the list was not who I thought the list, who was the list maker. How does the bells chime, the list maker goes? I don't know. Anyway, this book in the last third becomes so sick and twisted. Like, I'm sure that is not what the author like intended, but I have to be honest with you. Like, you know, I've said, I love those books like Girl on the Train and all those kinds of things are about these kind of like twisted characters. The character that makes the list in this book, she's twisted. I mean, I understand why she does what she does, but it's real, like even like up till the end, like of the homecoming dance, like she's real twisted. Like, she's lost her mind. And it's kind of interesting to see where she started and where she ends up. And for that, I mean, this book, I don't give stars in my reviews. I don't like to read reviews when they're like stars. Like, I mean, I do give on Goodreads, I give stars, but I usually always give fours or fives, even if I think it's crap, because I just feel bad for the author. I don't know. I mean, I've never like given a one. I mean, if somebody sits down for like months or weeks or years and writes a book, they deserve more than a one star, okay? I'm sorry, but they do. So anyway, or a two at that. So I always give like four or five stars to every book. So there's no point for me to even like rate books. But I'll just tell you, like if you want a fun summer read that's really quick, this is great. I mean, it is really, really good. In fact, it would probably be a really good book to read like at the beginning of high school, if you're in high school. There are some fantastic characters in the book in here. The character of Danielle, who they call Dan the Man, she changes so profoundly throughout the book. Like, I was like, and you know, like, this book did not wear me out. You know my wearing out thing, that if I say a book wore me out, that means I just, like, couldn't put it down. I wouldn't say I loved this book. I liked it a lot. I mean, I don't regret reading it. It was a good read, and I would recommend it to people, but it didn't wear me out. It didn't make me cry, any of that kind of stuff, but I did get kind of a little, like, feeling the emotions in my chest when it got towards the end and what happens to Danielle. And then the character of Sarah, I so related to. She was so me and my friends in high school. And so anyway, when you find out why the people were picked for the list, though, it even gets sicker. Okay, so this, I think, is a good, easy summer read. It's like 332 pages. You literally could read it in a day or two. I don't know why it took me so long to finish. I wish I just sat down and got through it. When I got to the halfway mark, I was, like, really into it. Like, I seriously last night was like... Like, I mean, and I didn't, like, sometimes I skim. Do you guys skim? Like, if I'm in a book and I'm just like, oh, like, I was watching a video the other day about somebody skimming. Oh, no, I was having this conversation today with a friend of mine, and I was asking him about the Game of Thrones books. And he was like, well, you can skim some stuff because, you know, it doesn't really apply to the overall concept of the book. And, like, sometimes I skim books, but I didn't skim a word in this book. It was that good. So, you guys should read it. The character development is great. The storyline is really good. It feels like you're watching, like, Pretty Little Liars or something like that on TV. So, that's it for my review of The List by Siobhan Vivian. Because I mispronounced her name the first time I said it. So, thank you to whoever corrected me. And I will talk to you later. Bye.